Okay. Welcome, and there you go. Ready to go.
Good morning. Now, as we make our smoothie this morning, I'm going to tell you about my morning as an example. Woke up about 6 o'clock, stayed in bed. I was very sore from yesterday's intense workouts. And I focused on truth and stabilizing my mind. What's the key element? And so I got recentered. So I recentered myself for about 2 hours. Then got up. And what's the most difficult thing to do in the morning? Stretch. I need a spoon here, don't I? So I stretched. Ah, painful, so painful. Then I did an intense workout. Trampoline, balance ball, weights, everything. It's like, wow, okay. Then, okay, now I'm going to do this awesome smoothie that you see here, which is papaya, 2 leaves of kale, an avocado, a banana, and some lemon juice, and then tart cherry juice and some chocolate protein drink. This is going to go into the smoothie. I don't know how I'm going to get it all in there, but I will. And this will be my breakfast, you see. So it's today's what, the eighth of October. Whew. So 21, 20, 33, 24, 25 days till this election, which is really a global issue. I talked to my Dutch friends, told me everyone in the world is watching this. He says it's got global implications. 25 days. So can we not, for 25 days, get up every morning and stretch, get up every morning and work out, get up every morning and center on what's important? If we can't do it now, when? See, this is the question. So let me go get a spoon. Okay, so let us commence here, as we're talking, with this amazing smoothie, papaya, about 2/3 of a papaya, okay, it's nice and ripe, so I'm going to try, not try, I am going to do it, and continue to push through over the finish line, right? Got to feel that you have really good habits going into this, the time that we're going into. Have to feel that you prove to yourself, okay, that you have good habits. This is essential. Don't just say you do, you have to prove it to yourself. So we're going to cut open this avocado. And it's ripe. I know it's going to be brownish and stuff inside. It's. I hope it's not too bad. Ah, it's not too bad. Okay, so we will just scoop the avocado out like that. It's ripe. It's a little goopy, but that's okay. In a smoothie, the avocado tastes fine when it's goopy like that. It's not a problem. So this one is just about just right to make a smoothie out of like this. Let's get the seed out of there. Avocado's a superfood for you. Really is. So is papaya. Not that that's going to turn you from an arrogant fool into guru vision, but it's a good habit, right? To have. Okay. Now, the banana. All this stuff's very, very good. You know, the best mixture for to help you out, antioxidants and anti-inflammatory, let's say anti-inflammatory, tart cherry juice, kale, and avocado. We have it all here. Plus the banana kicks in a lot of help too. So this is like a super smoothie right here. Have it all. Okay, there goes the banana. Now, we're going to try the lemon to give a little zip to it. I should have brought in some lemonade, actually, but I didn't. So we're going to put this in the squeezer here. Okay, and here goes the juice. Should I put a whole lemon in? Absolutely, I will. Okay, very great. So we're just ratcheting up our discipline, aren't we? As it gets closer, this is what we're supposed to be doing. Not falling back, ratcheting it up, getting better and better and better at it. Very great. Yeah. Okay. So there we have the lemon juice is in there. Now, the kale. And I'll break this up a little bit. Two pieces of wonderful kale. Superfood. Mix it with the rest of this stuff. And okay, now we'll put in the tart cherry juice. I can get the lid off, which I can't because my hands are wet. Okay, there you go. And a little more here. Can't pop it. Let's see. Okay. Got it. And we'll put in a little chocolate protein drink. Gives a little flavor, chocolatey flavor to it, which is nice. All right. There we go. So this is pretty exotic looking, isn't it? If you want to take a close up here. Very exotic. I should make a video just of this mixture here as the chocolate protein powder is making its way down in the sides. Isn't this? This is extraordinary. It's beautiful, actually. Maybe I just leave it that way as an ornamentation. Wow. That is really cool. The oiliness of the chocolate drink is just not blending with the cherry juice. So I don't even want to blend this. Can I just leave it like this? That's awesome. Wow, I'm just going to look at that. Beautiful. Smoothie art, right? Holy cow. Well, that is really something. Alrighty. And pretty soon it's going to be homogenized. Kind of like the world's going to be homogenized very soon into foolish arrogance. Foolish arrogance. Or arrogant foolishness. Arrogant fools. We're all arrogant fools. This is the primary recognition that we either entertain arrogant foolishness or entertain guru vision, which is being aware of intrinsic spaciousness. It's one or the other. Those are the only two options we have. And seeing this is the heart of repentance, actually. This is what we're trying to avoid in the world right now. There's a collective effort in the world to, at all costs, avoid this recognition. Well, so it's very difficult to reach people right now because they're trying to avoid this recognition. And I'm trying to say, this is the recognition you need. Just this one recognition. I'm either have the perspective of an arrogant fool or the perspective of guru vision. And there's no in-between at all. None. This is the heart of the direct approach, what we have to get to. And the world is trying its utmost to avoid this in every possible way. It's like this smoothie. It's just all sort of mixtures here. Oh my gosh, this is really amazing. Okay. So, my helpfulness is to avoid the folly of the world now. To recognize that it's either or. To choose guru vision, and then down the road, when there'll be a point when everyone says, oh my gosh, how stupid we were. Oh, I hope we didn't, you know, destroy all guru vision. I hope there's some that haven't, because that was, like, we knew it was wrong, but we did it anyway. That kind of thing. You know, like kids, juveniles, they know it's wrong, but they do it anyway. Later they say, how stupid I was. So we're in a very juvenile mode in the world right now, where we're going to do something very bad. And then later on, the regrets will hit us so strongly, let me just say. And we said, oh, I hope there's some adults around, you know, because I just, that was so juvenile. And then the adults show up and say, hey, yeah, no problem. Okay, now let's get down to business and recognize, repent. And they'll say, oh, wonderful, thank you so much. I'm so relieved, I'm so relieved. So that's down the road. Right now, I'm not having much influence in the world because of the juvenile nature of the world right now, that the juveniles think they've got it all figured out, right? They don't. Trying to get fancy with, okay. Here we go. Say goodbye to this food art, smoothie art. Smoothie, where art thou? Can we do it? It never tends to go the first time. It's so cranky, I don't know why. No, it doesn't go that way. It's like the third time it always goes. I don't understand this. Let me see. This? Not even the third time. It says, I don't want to ruin this beautiful smoothie art. Gosh. It says, no, I must keep the smoothie art. It's too beautiful. Homogenized. We're all homogenized, bureaucratized into this homogenous muck. Alright? Oh. Yeah, it really is a muck. A green muck. Oh, it turns into a green muck. Oh, it was so beautiful before. Oh my gosh. But I couldn't really drink it that way. Holy cow. I don't know. It takes an effort of will, faith, to drink it, right? Pretty good. I'll drink some of it, and then I'll put some more juice in to make it less, you know, less thick. Thin it out. So this is a super. You saw what went in here. This is what I'm drinking, taking in. I have a chocolate chaser. That's a good idea. And a cherry chaser. So this is so thick. You want a chaser to kind of wash it out of your mouth. Tastes great. Avocado is very good for blending in smoothies. It gives a really smooth texture to it. I know this is gross, but it's a good gross. You have to be mentally tough to do this. And believe me, I wasn't born this way. It's taken me a year to get this mentally tough on these smoothies, really. I mean, the idea of avocado, no. I said, no, no, no way. Kale, no way. I wouldn't do any of this stuff. So this is just recently I've been able to push through these mental blocks, but it's taken a long time. But pressure, you know, desperation, pressure, realizing is important. that really helps us out. I just have this mental focus, like, that's able to get past some of these barriers now. It's not easy. I'll do a cherry chase or two now. So, can I power it through? Well, I wanted to show you I can drink the whole thing. The lemon juice helps a lot. They make it more, you know, palatable. Did it. Wow. This is the secret. So, smoothie secrets with Smoothie Ross here. We're discovering this as we go along. Putting in that fresh lemon juice, that's super helpful. Having a chocolate chaser like this is super helpful. You want to get something really flavorful in your mouth after you've been chugging this. And that this chocolate just does it. Wonderful. Oh, wow. This is a psychological thing. I've never been able to drink this whole thing at one time. It's a lot. You're drinking this green sludge, you know, and it's like, can I do this? Now, it's got a lot of stuff, residuals in there. You see that? So, what I'll do is I'll pour some cherry juice in there. Put this lid back on and shake it up so I get all that stuff off the sides. This is another trick. See, now it's just all liquefied in the cherry juice. And then I'll chug this. And, this is one of the most intense videos I've ever made. Wow. Did it. Holy cow. That last cherry juice part was the toughest. I was so full. The great thing about this is this liquid, the fullness, will quickly subside. Quickly subside. It's not like some big heavy meal in your stomach that sits there. So you can see that the nutrition that we just pounded down here. I mean, we're just a total, you know, spread cruncher, you know, smoothie cruncher here. We just crunch it down. Needs to be another word for it. It's like an altered experience, actually. I just just had an altered experience, really. I won't call it a near-death experience, but it's something similar, actually. A near-life experience. Just like, because mentally, it was a mental barrier to get it complete, drink all of that in one sitting like this. An extreme sport. Maybe this should be like food eating contest, you know, smoothie contest. How many smoothies like that can you drink? Okay, I just... I'm weak now. I'm like, what did I do? So there you go. It has been done. Maybe I'm ready to ascend now. Possibly. So what a way to start the day. It's like 10:15. I've already had, you know, tremendous meditation, tremendous workout, tremendous nutritional experience here, food experience, and we're just getting started on the day. So this is possible, okay? It's possible. I just showed this. Our days can be like this. And yet, we're choosing to be arrogant fools. Okay, not be, that's the wrong word. We're choosing to have the perspective of an arrogant fool. We are perfect. We can never actually be an arrogant fool, but we can have this perspective of an arrogant fool. And the world is choosing this. And we have to recognize it and admit it. Now, going pro is to recognize this and say it's either one or the other. There's nothing else other than that, and I choose to be I choose guru vision rather than the perspective of arrogant foolishness. That's all. That's what going pro is. So I've gone pro, and just like the parallel of my golf. 44 years of misery, of never being feeling like I don't have the right feeling hitting it. I just don't have the right feeling. I just don't quite have it. I don't know what it is, but I know I don't have it. I'm still arrogantly foolish. So I went out a couple days ago to the driving range. The Longchenpa said, I want you to go out there. I said, okay. I said, look, if I go out there, I'll do that, but you have to fix my swing. Got a deal? He said, yeah. Deal. I said, wow, okay, I did it. And in 10 minutes, he fixed my swing. And I got the feeling that I've never had before, 44 years. I said, oh, so that's the feeling. Okay, that's the pro feeling. This is what the pros feel. I felt what the pros feel. I said, oh, okay, wow. That's going pro. You get this feeling that the pros have. It's a feeling. It's a feeling. Because you got it. You know you got it. And then you get used to that feeling. And it's the professionals. You can see that there's this confidence, this feeling, that they're used to feeling a certain feeling. Whereas we're like still arrogantly foolish. And we think that there's something else other than arrogant foolishness or guru vision. There's something else. No, that is the arrogant foolishness. That there's some third category that doesn't exist. We can get to it. We're progressing towards something else. That's arrogant foolishness. You'll never have the pro feeling when you have an arrogant foolish feeling, actually. And you try to get rid of it, you know, somehow. Lots of different ways. We're always trying some way to get rid of that arrogant foolishness feeling. We don't never feel quite right, do we, in life? We never feel quite right. Uh, When you go pro, then you feel right. I say, oh, I feel right now. Okay. Yeah, I can feel this is the right way to feel. Guru vision, intrinsic spaciousness. Vision of intrinsic spaciousness. It's either that or perspective of arrogant foolishness. Those are the two options we have. And right now the world is saying, no, we can find a third option if we all work together. Let's get really activist about this and let's coordinate and organize. And this is called spiritual materialism or materialism. Very organized, you know, very calculating, all everything's chipped and everything, so everything can run faster. That's arrogant foolishness. And this is what the world is doing now. It's obsessed with it. More and more getting pulled down by that, right? They're struggling against it, and they could feel, oh, no, I don't want to be pulled down. Don't worry. The pros have your back. Down the road, you'll recenter, okay, and be able to then get with it, repent, and start working on just this one shift, a decision. Decide to go pro. Commit to going pro. Commit to it. Keep committing. At some point, your commitment will push through all the way, and you'll get that feeling. Say, ah, this is it. This is it. That's all. Okay, this is it. First time I had the experience of intrinsic spaciousness, immediately I just said, oh, so this is it. Okay. I recognize it right away. So, oh, okay, this is it. This is what the gurus are talking about. Right away, it's this. Okay, that's it. Simple. I said, wow, it's so simple. How could I have overlooked that? That's amazing. Only arrogant foolishness could possibly overlook it, right? So I said, well, I've been an arrogant fool. Yeah, we all have been arrogant fools. We're all have this perspective of arrogant foolishness. It's either that or guru vision. If you don't have the vision of intrinsic spaciousness, you're entertaining the perspective of an arrogant fool. No two ways around it. But very few will admit that right now in the world. Very few. No, you know, I'm smart, I'm intelligent, I'm not an arrogant fool. Yeah, that's part of being an arrogant fool, being smart and intelligent and all this stuff. I'm efficient, I can do this, I can do all this stuff. I'm searching. No. So, admitting that you're an arrogant fool, as far as your perspective, okay, I have an arrogant fool perspective. Admitting that to yourself, to others, you say, yeah, this is true. This is the huge step. And these wonderful Dharma kings, they help us with that by telling us directly, yeah, this is so. And it's not easy to hear it, but the more you keep hearing it, gradually you get more comfortable. Say, it's okay. The more educated you are, the more difficult it is, I think. Those who are highly educated have a very difficult time with this. Yeah, I stopped paying attention to education in seventh grade. So that's it. No, that's not the way. So, you know, I didn't have as much as a struggle. I still struggle with it, but I worked at it and said, you know what? I think I'm maybe really stupid and arrogant and thinking I can do the impossible. But the more educated.